destroy this invisible government, to dissolve the unholy alliance between corrupt business and corrupt politics, is the first task of the statesmanship of the day. Unhampered by tradition, uncorrupted by power, undismayed by the magnitude of the task, the decent one who offers itself as the instrument, to sweep away old abuses, to build a new and nobler nation. This declaration is our covenant with them, and we hereby bind upon this candidate state admission to the pledges made herein. With all my heart and soul, every particle of my purpose, I pledge you my word to do everything I can to put every particle of courage, of common sense, and strength that I have at your disposal, and to endeavor so far as strength is given me to live up to the obligations you have put upon me, and to endeavor to carry out in the interests of our whole people the policies to which you have today solemnly dedicated yourselves in the name of the millions of men and women for whom you speak. Surely there never was a fight better worth making than the one in which we are engaged. It little matters what befalls any one of us who for the time being stands at the forefront of that. I hope we shall win, and I believe that if we can wake the people to what the fight really means, we shall. But win or lose, we shall not. Whatever fate may at the moment overtake any of us, the movement itself will not. Our cause is based on the eternal principles of righteousness. Even though we now make the time fail, yet the cause itself shall rise. I spoke to the honest representatives of a convention that was not dominated by honesty. A convention wherein sat, alas, the majority of men who, with sneering indifference for every principle of life, so acted as to bring to a shameful end a body which had been founded over half a century ago by many who so burnt the fire of poverty and hell. Now the two men, who in your turn have come together to spend and spend,